Welcome back, and welcome to my channel. This is Philip, and we're gonna jump back in and play some more Spelunky. Things didn't go quite as according to plan as I would have liked last time, but the point is to chill out, play games, and have some fun, so it's okay. The walls are shifting. Some money straight off the bat, it's nice. I can hear the dog. Down next to the exit, I think. Don't know how I missed those. Leave him alive. No need to kill anything if it's not in our way. Tempting, but I don't know if there's any shops around tonight. Prefer not to be a terrorist, so. So I don't think it would have reached the shop, but oh, that was silly. I'm also not 100% sure, so. Oof. That's the one thing that always really, really tempts me. A jetpack isn't exactly a free win, but mobility is really key. We're 100 shy. Ugh. No, we're gonna go. I could have blown up a wall and gotten some extra gold there, but I don't know, it's just often doesn't quite feel worth it. So we've got our eye. Oh! Why don't I just fly across the map for myself? Ooh! That was close. So much for the live and let live. There's been an awful lot of killing on this map. Oh my god, right, that's that's one run done. Whoops. On to the next one. Lesson learned, be a little bit more careful. been slightly impressive if it had been on purpose, but I had meant for the damsel to kill both the spider and the bat. There's a spider over there. Giant spider. I'm going to get his sticky bomb paste. Take that, thank you. I'm a big fan of the sticky gloves. Again, mobility just being key. If you've got the jetpack, it basically gives you infinite use because you can stick to a wall to recharge the jetpack. But on the ice level, specifically, sticky gloves really just give you so much mobility. And in a snake pit like this as well. It's just brilliant. Okay. Sometimes the sticky gloves can be a slight nuisance, getting yourself stuck to walls you didn't quite want to, but went out of my way to went out of my way to practice enough with them where that wouldn't happen. Oh no. Oh, and I'm out of bombs. That's dangerous. And I don't have spiky boots, so I will just bounce on his head. And we don't want that. That was very silly. Wow. Okay, we're just gonna leave. Jesus. Okay. We're doing okay in terms of okay, we were doing okay in terms of money and health. No longer. Tried to jump over a snake and just jumped headfirst into an arrow trap. That's okay. As I keep telling my son, when you lose, you learn. Another one of those instances where kind of hoping for that trap to go off and it's really not doing what I want it to. Jesus. Okay. a slightly different way. Ah, all that for a parachute. Be out of uses, but definitely getting my money's worth on that one. Almost in ghost time, though. Music warps because of the ghost. Oh well. One health going into the jungles. What could possibly go wrong? I mean, I've more than gotten the money I need for the black market to get the ankh, but no bombs, so I probably should conserve my pickaxe for once I see the blip. Oof. I've gone for the dog there. I could hear him. Oh, of course it's a dark level. And I've got no glasses. Alright. Just gonna be crazy careful and see if lucky with the black market door. Can see the and there we go. Okay, gonna call it there for episode 2. Thanks for joining me, and hopefully next time we'll go a little bit better.